They come in all kinds of different shapes and colors. Some may resemble sticks, others leaves, some even look like flowers. Welcome to Nature Explores Insects, presented by the Danbury Public Library. We explore the wonderful, amazing world of insects, bugs, and arachnids. This week, we're looking at the praying mantis. Praying mantises get their name from how they hold their front legs. The position reminds people of praying. Many cultures associate the praying mantis with calm and serenity, but that's not the whole story. Mantises are actually ambush predators with lightning-fast moves. There are around 2,000 known species of praying mantis around the world. They can be found in many different habitats throughout the world, including rainforests, deserts, grasslands, meadows, and even in our own backyards. Some people even keep praying mantises as pets. Praying mantises can reach lengths of around 4 to 6 inches long. They have long necks and an interesting triangular head. They can turn their heads a full 180 degrees around. That's an entire half circle. In fact, they are the only insects that can turn their heads. Being able to turn their head instead of having to turn their whole body as well lets them look all around them without alerting their prey. When we look at a mantis, we see two large eyes looking back at us. Now, two eyes are great, but mantises have more. They have 5 eyes. Their extra 3 eyes are located in the middle of their head. Cool, huh? Those 3 little extra eyes are used to detect light, while the 2 large compound eyes are for seeing movement. They also allow the mantis to do something that no other insect can. They can see in 3D or stereoscopically like we can. Each of their 2 large main eyes has a fovea, a collection area of photoreceptor cells that helps them focus and track movement. This keen eyesight is part of what makes mantises such successful hunters. But it gets even more interesting. Not only can mantises see in 3 dimensions, scientists have discovered that their vision works differently than any other currently known creature in nature, including us. We can easily notice the details around us, even if things aren't moving. So if we look at a teddy bear sitting on a bed, we can easily see how fluffy the bear is and what color the fur is, and if the nose is made of a shiny plastic or a soft thread. But mantises, they don't see the world that way. They don't notice details, only movement. They look for areas where what they're seeing changes. So why is this so important to scientists? Robots. Scientists are hoping that by studying how mantises see, they can develop a better vision method for robots. Currently, robots use stereoscopic vision that is based on our vision, which is actually very complex and takes a lot of processing power for the robot. It is believed that the mantis' way of seeing the world, by searching for where things changes more than just being able to see all of the details, would work out better for robots. It's just as effective as our sight, but it takes less processing power. This process of looking towards nature for solutions for technology is called biomimicry, and is something that scientists do a lot. Praying mantises are masters of camouflage. They come in all kinds of different shapes and colors. Some may resemble sticks, others leaves, some even look like flowers. Certain mantises change their color as they molt or shed their skin as they grow, starting out a green during the spring and ending up a brown in the late summer and early fall when the grass is dry and the leaves are starting to lose their color. This makes it easier for them to hide in all that brown that's starting to show up in the world, right? Yeah. Others will molt into a black covering, all the better to help them to blend in with the blackened landscape in areas where numerous bushfires happen. These amazing insects have a voracious appetite. It means they eat lots and lots of food. And they are very successful hunters. They're carnivores. That means they're meat eaters. And they like live prey, consisting mainly of other insects, including many of the insects that hurt our crops. Their front legs have rows of sharp spines on them to help them hold on to their meal, which they usually begin to eat head first. But insects aren't all they eat. They also enjoy munching on spiders, frogs, small lizards, and even small birds like hummingbirds and honey eaters. If it comes within grabbing distance of their front legs, a praying mantis will try to catch it. They use their camouflage to lay in wait for something to come close, standing nice and still, relying on their amazing eyes to detect movement and tell them whether something is within striking distance. Once it is, they latch out with their front legs and grab hold. Sometimes they even decide to stalk their prey, moving slowly and carefully towards what they want to eat until they're close enough to pounce. Now, unfortunately for praying mantises, many other creatures think that they're tasty as well. These creatures include frogs, lizards, birds, certain spiders, and bats. But the mantis has an interesting way of avoiding the bat. See, mantises can detect a bat's echolocation sounds through a special hearing organ in the middle of their belly area. It only hears high-pitched sounds and feels vibrations. Being able to hear high-pitched sounds is important because that's what a bat's echolocation call sounds like. When the bat's high-pitched chirps come in contact with the mantis's body, it realizes the bat's too close, and it goes into a dive towards the ground, spiraling and looping the way down. This often throws off the bat, making the bat miss the mantis it is trying to catch. Now, if the bat gets lucky and happens to catch the mantis uses their big, spiky front legs to fight back and attack the bat. All this means that sometimes it's easier for the bat to go after a moth rather than a mantis if it happens to see one flying around at night. Now, while they're active from now in the spring until the first frost, we don't usually see praying mantis that much until the early to mid-fall. That's their mating season, a time when they're actually out wandering around and trying to find other mantises. They leave their protective areas where we don't see them too much, and we might actually see them on our sidewalks, or maybe perched on the side of our houses, or maybe even on top of bushes. They're trying to find other mantises. This is also the time when the female mantis will be laying her eggs, which will hatch the next spring. Now, when threatened, praying mantises don't run away or fly off like most insects. Instead, they do a threat display. They stand up tall on their legs, raise their front legs high, and puff out their wings, all to make themselves look as big as possible. Now, it looks kind of silly to us, almost like they're dancing, but it actually works. Many animals are suspicious of something that doesn't try to run away. After all, it might be venomous, or have a stinger, or might be able to give you a nasty bite. So they try to avoid it. So the question is, do mantises actually have stingers? Can they hurt us? No, they can't. Mantises have no venom in them and no stingers. While it's true they can bite us if we provoke them, for the most part, mantises really don't care about humans. We're too big to eat, so we're not a food source. And for the most part, they don't feel threatened by us. If we come across kind of quickly and startle it, it might do a threat display. And then if we try and pick it up then, it might try and bite us. And it might actually stick us a little bit with those front legs that have those spikes. But it feels kind of like getting a paper cut. They don't have any ability to make us itchy or to put venom in us that is painful. They're just going to give us a little nip. But if we approach mantises carefully and quietly, we can actually get them on our hands and they will stay there and walk around and they're not going to bother us. They really don't care about humans. So what kind of mantises do we have around here? Well, the ones we have are called European mantises. In fact, they're our stace insect. They're green in the spring through the summer months and then become brownish in the fall as they start to change so they can blend in with the dying grass and the browning leaves. So next time you're outside, keep an eye out for these little guys. If you're lucky, you might see one in your garden or hiding in a bush or maybe even walking along the sidewalk. And if you do see one of these guys wandering around, you shouldn't harm it. You should just observe it, and maybe if you're nice and careful and gentle, you might even be able to pick it up. Thank you for joining me this week on Nature Explores Insects. Until next time, stay safe, stay happy, and stay curious. Bye, everyone.